by about midway through the show.
We'll be able to stretch, right?
Yes.
Okay, thanks.
We take two breaks. So we stretch, we do jumping jacks, and we get limber for the rest of the show.
I like it.
So I guess we could just dive in and learn a little bit about you guys and where you focus in and what you're seeing out there in the marketplace.
Okay.
So, a little background about you guys.
Yeah, of course. Okay, you can start.
Well, first I just have to say I love that Foo Fighters introduction song. So
that gets me going. I just changed the intro music up. It's nice.
Yeah. Well, our background is we love real estate. We love to sell real estate. We've been doing this since 2004. I'm part owner of RE/MAX Access and the Summers team. You know, Stephanie has been with me since about, 2005?
Yeah, 2005 I got my license and joined forces with the famous Chris Summers.
The power duo.
The husband and wife duo, very nice. So your office is in Northern Libs, correct?
Correct.
Now, really the whole focus of our show and the whole vision of it is and from a national level and a local level, all the media is doom and gloom. And you guys as real estate professionals and myself being in the mortgage business, we know that's not necessarily true.
I agree.
Because negative media sells newspapers, it gets website clicks, and it essentially creates a panic, and it's unwarranted.
I totally agree. We have seen, like nationally, I mean, we can't really speak nationally. We read the same, you know, articles that everybody else reads, and we know that there are a lot of places that are really hurting. So we can't make light of it and say, oh, you know, like every realtor, oh, the market's great, the market's great. But, you know, in the Philadelphia market, it is good. We're resilient. We're a strong, the Philadelphia and surrounding area, we're a strong, you know, we have a strong economy comparatively to other places.
Right.
So yeah, we're hurting a little bit, but as far as real estate's concerned, I mean, we're busy. We're very busy.
We've taken our punches a lot better than other areas of the country. So for instance, we always refer to everything's real, all things in real estate are local. And especially here, it's Philadelphia never saw as big of a boom as many of the other cities out there that are also seeing a huge bust. You know, a lot of the bubble cities were speculative parts of the country where people were really rose up and there's huge population growth like parts of California,
right.
Phoenix and everything, but Philadelphia is a deep-rooted city and has a pretty broad-based economy that's really helped us weather the storm a lot better than other areas.
Yeah, I mean, from what the popular media is saying about Philadelphia is that we didn't boom to the degree where we completely destroyed ourselves, which is good. We still stayed relatively conservative even though we did partake in that market bubble. So, but yeah, that's all accurate. I totally agree. Do you agree, Chris?
Absolutely. And you know, to add to that, the Philadelphia average sales price, you know, is very affordable. So the affordability index, you know, buyers can step in, and oftentimes their mortgage payment, you know, is going to be lower than a rental payment.
Yeah.
And when you compound adding a mortgage interest deduction and a lot of other factors, it's just an extremely smart decision. There's just a lot of factors that make the opportunity high, and that, you know, where we are, you know, we do a lot of sales in the fringe areas, like outside, you know, of maybe the higher, you know, sales price in Center City at Rittenhouse Square. There's just a lot of volume and a lot of activity and a lot of real estate sales that might not get talked about, you know, in the media in this doom and gloom. So, you know, what we see is we have settlements, you know, every week. We have settlements sometimes almost every day, you know, in our office, and a lot of times just our deals, you know, personally, Paul. So,
right.
You know, there's just a lot of activity, and that's both on the buyer side and on the seller side as well.
The doom and gloom, it's just not as dark out there as a lot of the media is saying. We see a lot. We don't even see it. We don't just see a light, you know, at the end of the tunnel. I mean, we see a bright sunny day. We really do.
What areas of the city do you guys see a lot of activity going on?
Well, Chris mentioned the fringe area. I mean, that's, we have a real, you know, love for the fringe area. And we consider the fringe area, if you look at Center City, as like the center of the donut, and everything around Center City within, a 5-mile radius, that's like our fringe section. So if I dropped a couple names, it would be like Northern Liberties, Fishtown, Old Kensington or Kensington South, New Kensington, which is like a right outside of Fishtown, the Francisville, which is associated with the Art Museum, Graduate Hospital, even Point Breeze, and some of Grays Ferry, and then we're looking at Passyunk Square, you know, Pennsport, that those sort of places. So if you look at those things on a map, they basically make a horseshoe. I'm going to say donut just because it's round and I like round things, but they make a horseshoe around the city, and those are the places where people can afford homes. So first-time buyers are going to find the product that satisfies them that they can afford, and they are going to be building a lot of equity in those homes over the next, you know, 3 to 5 years. They're going to have a nice little chunk of money where they can either move out of the city or move to a more maybe exclusive neighborhood in the city,
sure,
or whatever it is that their goals are.
And like we were talking about, what is a good definition of recovery? I feel we've truly hit the bottom, and we're going to continue to move forward and make small incremental gains. Now, a lot of people might have a perception and remember the boom of this crazy time where prices are going to go up 10-20% a year.
But that wasn't even healthy.
Well, it's not going to happen again. So we need to set realistic expectations and realize that that wasn't real, and that due to loose underwriting standards and anybody could get a mortgage off the streets, it helped fuel that demand and that bubble.
And speaking of your loose mortgage, right now the mortgage industry is so tight, and it is like swimming through molasses. Really, it's the deals now, although there are plenty of them going on, it is very challenging to make it through even the most, you know, seemingly straightforward process. So what I mean by that is, like, if you're a homeowner or you're a buyer and you're under contract to purchase a home, and you're just like a regular everyday buyer, you don't have complicated taxes, you make a great living, you pay your taxes, you know, you've got a decent income, good credit score, even then the mortgage industry has such tight standards that even the simplest deal can become a challenge. Not impossible, but you definitely feel like you're more wrestling deals to a table these days instead of just sliding on in.